Gamblers Log 8, dealing with frustrations. Well, that's the problem that I'm having right now. Dealing with frustrations. In the last Captain's Log, I stated that I have a tendency to have a very short temper. Shorter than I would actually like to admit. And imagine at that you know, point of being absolutely angry, that I need to actually sort of mask that kind of rage inside me so that I don't really repulse anybody that I talk to. So there's that. But dealing with frustrations. Today, I believe I found out my crew was getting lonely, you know, separated from their families, you know, separated from the mainland. The isolation is getting to them, you know, that the sea is vast. It's been about a month since we beached. The provisions are not running low. Because technically they are in check almost every day, except for that one crewmate that just happens to just grab an extra Twinkie during lunch. So how the fuck would he do that? I don't know. But it's probably a part of that loneliness. Because I found out from a famous neuroscientist, Dr. Andrew Huberman. You might know him. And the people here don't know him, but there in the mainland, he is a very well-known neuroscientist. He discusses these science-based experiments for everyday life, for the general public, etc., etc. So, one of the things that they actually said is that dopamine is actually released through let's say anticipation of something that you don't know actually exists. Now it's sort of this. If you want something and you don't necessarily see it at this point in time, then these ill-informed opinions form in your mind, you know, that place with your civility at times, and then you just happen to act on your impulses to satiate that kind of hunger that dopamine gives you. You know, now what does that mean? Well, dopamine is triggered by the sense of pursuit and anticipation. Now, since dopamine is released almost every day here at the ship, because we are anticipating reaching the rendezvous point on time and on the right place and not get stranded in the middle of the ocean with no fuel, no food, and just freezing to death, you know, so that's not ideal at all. So, and that's what I said about the previous Captain's Log, is that the radar is playing tricks on us, on our mind. Sometimes the radar is completely understandable, reasonable even, that the rendezvous point is fixed for about a really long time. And once we actually get to that position, it shifts into another position that is off the map. Somewhere north, somewhere south, somewhere west, somewhere east. It shifts almost every day. Now, I don't know if that's a radar problem or if I need to follow one path, stick to it, and don't let anybody deter me. Now, there's that. So, the ocean is vast, and somehow that vastness forces me onto these people in this kind of confined space. So we're here together. I'm the crew, I'm the captain, I lead the crew, they follow me. But that doesn't mean that they are completely agreeable. Now, I say this with a degree of conscientiousness, that loneliness is getting to them. And this kind of loneliness leads them to be completely and utterly just disorganized, unknowledgeable. They are just rampant around the ship. Now, earlier this day, they were forcing me to do something that I don't want to do, you know. So I won't conform, I won't give in to the peer pressure, but it can get frustrating and annoying. So there's that, and I needed to deal with that frustration as well. So in dealing with that frustration, I decided to completely ignore them. So yeah, that's it. Keep sailing, Captain's Log 8.